Hi everyone, welcome to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. So behind me I've got Seborina, because I am in Lithuania. I've flown down from London to Lithuania for a couple of weeks. I need a break, but I do want to continue playing tennis. So I called up Seborina, organized an hour training session with one of the coaches, and I will be playing today on a hard court. Why am I telling you all this? Well, because while I'm doing my 1 hour training session, I will be wearing the Huawei GT2e as well as the Amazfit GTR. So we want to compare the two trackers. If you're new to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews, we talk about the latest tech news. We do brutally honest reviews and share hacks and tricks along the way. So make sure to hit that subscribe button and bell notification so you don't miss out. We want to see how they record the steps I take, the energy I burn. We want to see how they're actually going to track the exercises, because I'm not sure that the GTR actually has a sport mode called tennis. But because Huawei and Honor do have the 100 sport modes, we do hope that tennis will be available. Anyway, I think it's time for me to go and change, so I'll go and do that, but I will catch up with you on the tennis court. So having bounced the ball for about an hour on the tennis court got me really, really tired. By the time we were done, I thought my heart is going to pop out. Like, really. I was panting more than my friend's bulldog on a hot sunny day. But the important thing is, I did have my Huawei GT2e and the Amazfit GTR on my wrists recording the workout. As I mentioned earlier, the GTR did not have the tennis profile, so I had to use Freestyle instead. But because Honor and Huawei do share the same internals, Huawei GT2e did have the 100 sport modes, and tennis was one of them. The excellent thing is, inside sports, I chose tennis, I just tapped on it, and it got added automatically into my favorites. How cool is that? So even though the sport modes were different, tennis versus freestyle, I expected that at least the basics, such as the heart rate, would be similar. Boy, was I wrong. So in order to normalize the results, what did I do? This morning, I went out for a brisk walk. Both watches do have the outdoor walk sport profile or activity profile. And more importantly, both of these trackers actually do have inbuilt GPS. So they can actually record not just the distance covered, but my speed, my cadence, etc. Thankfully, the results in heart rate were approximately the same. So the average heart rate was 116 beats per minute on both the trackers. So the lows and the maxes were slightly out, but at least the average was the same. Stride length and cadence were within 10% of each other, so not too bad. What I did find strange though is that the GPS readings were out by quite a bit. And that's funny because again, they were on my wrist and I traveled that one distance. The difference in the distance was not huge, but it was there nonetheless. Look, I know there's going to be a lot of stats and data in this review and comparison, but I will be breaking it down into manageable chunks because we really do need to understand which of these watches can track your health metrics more accurately. And we also need to understand which of these watches actually tracks your fitness more accurately. I have structured the comparison in the following way. First, we'll take a close look at the heart rate, the steps, the pace, the cadence, and other health metrics that the watches calculated during my two workouts, and all the usual bits that we cover in the WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. So to start us off, let's look into the past workout widgets of both the watches. We'll kick off with the Amazfit GTR. Firstly, let's check out what the bands show us from the past workout screens. From the tennis workout, we clearly see that the GTR stats are summarized to the max and just showing us the bare basics, such as calories burned, duration, heart rate plot, and heart rate zones. If initially I thought that was due to the freestyle workout widget, the second activity, and that's the brisk outdoor walk, proves that the Amazfit GTR is not exactly generous with data displayed on your watch face. You get a view of your activity duration, distance, steps covered, speed, heart rate, cadence, stride length,
calorie consumption, and then your heart rate zones and the heart rate plot. The cherry on top is a map outline of the walk I did. How useful is it? Well, it isn't really, simply because it doesn't have any details on it, you can't tap into it, but it definitely does look cool. But hey, it's not all bad. When you jump into the Zep app, you get smacked with data overload. The overview screen is mega intuitive. Just take a look at that map. It integrates satellite view, distance markers, as well as background removal. Check out the key below the map, green for slow and red for fast. Under the key, you get a load of general data with the likes of time, steps taken, cadence, speed. It's all there. No need to change screens. All you do is swipe down and it takes you automatically to the charts. You get plots with speed, heart rate and heart rate zones, altitude change and laps. But the coolest part is that you can do plot overlays. For example, overlay your speed plot with your heart rate. Insightful? Definitely. As you can see, the Huawei Health app is also good. The white background is a stark contrast to the rich black of the Zep app. You can expand the plots, your heart rate and cadence, but you cannot do the overlays. Let's check out the Huawei GT2e's past workout widget. Wowzers. Now that's what I call detailed. So here you also get the distance speed data, including pace and average speed. You get steps, cadence and stride length. Elevation data is both written and plotted on a chart. Same as pace and cadence plots, by the way. The heart rate plot is also broken down into zones. And once again, we see the training effect and recovery time. But most importantly for the athlete in you, you have the VO2 max. All things considered, let's summarize our findings. Okay, so with Amazfit GTR, past activities widget is not very informative. GPS accuracy is okay, derived from the fact that from the 4.7 kilometer walk, it went astray by approximately 80 meters, which is about 2%. Zep, aka Amazfit app, is stunning to look at and very informative, allowing for great visuals and fitness metric overlays. Let's take a look at Huawei GT2e. It has a stunning past workout widget. There are heaps of vital stats and the plots are bright and colorful, really popping off the screen at you. GPS accuracy is within 10 meters from a total distance of 4.7 kilometers. I think the dual GPS and GLONASS setup is showing itself here. The Huawei Health app is detailed and insightful with zoom-in functionality for the heart rate and other key metric charts. But the charts do not have the overlay function as the Zep app. Let's take a look at the design variations between the two watches. So they're both designed like sport watches. The buttons are laid out at the 2 and 4 o'clock, as we saw on the Honor Magic Watch 2 and the Huawei GT. But the GT is sportier yet. The lugs have been smoothed out for a more solid appearance that's separated from other siblings. There is just one dial size for the GT2e, and that is 46 millimeters, as opposed to 42.6 millimeters on the GTR. The GT2e is significantly larger, and you can clearly see that from how the watch sits on my wrist. I don't think the GT2e is too large though. The lugs taper down and hug the watch to the wrist comfortably. Another interesting feature is that the watch case sits just under 11 millimeters on my wrist, so it's still very much slim. The weight is 43 grams without the straps. The GTR case is brushed aluminium for sturdiness and long-lasting wearing. It's feather light at only 25.5 grams without the strap. And as mentioned, the ceramics bezel sharpens up the watch to look closer to a classic watch rather than a smartwatch. The GT2e, like its predecessor, the GT2, has a 1.39-inch screen with a resolution of 454 by 454 pixels. The AMOLED display is lightning quick and responsive. The display is nicely detailed with text and stats easily readable in direct sunlight, mid-exercise, or in most other environments. The screen itself is one of the Amazfit GTR's best features. The 42mm version has a 390 by 390 1.2-inch AMOLED touch-activated display, which ends up with 326 ppi, and mind you, that's identical to Honor Magic Watch 2 42mm and the infamous Apple Watch Series 5. Bright colors looked vibrant on both watch faces. You can choose from plenty of watch faces from the Zep app or the Huawei Health app. The displays respond to the usual swipe and tap and hold motions. The blacks are very deep, the detail on the watch faces is spectacular, and as you can see, there's no issues with reading values off the screen outdoors. Being flagship models, auto brightness is also available on both, as well as always-on displays, adjusting screen timeouts, and so forth. Pricing does play an important role. The GT2e is priced at £159 in UK or $180 in US, in official stores, electronic and mobile phone physical stores, while the GTR costs £129 or $170. Now, considering the wearables I review and test are not sponsored and I have to buy the wearables myself, I'm out looking for bargains all the time. Physical stores are not options for me at all. Think about it. They have to pay for premises, staff, other overheads, and of course all these things are priced into the tech they sell. I don't see why I should be helping them make their bank. Now, AliExpress prices are usually much lower. Orders are usually delivered to London, UK within 7 to 10 days. If you're based in Asia or Eurasia, I would think deliveries are significantly quicker. Let's take a look at some of these prices. You can get the GTR for only $135. That's like £100. Bargain? Definitely. Let's look at the GT2e. You can get it for $120. That's approximately £90. Again, huge bargain. I have provided some links in the description below the video for some really sharp prices. I am an affiliate of AliExpress, so if you do make a purchase, I'll get a small commission that doesn't affect your price, but it helps support the channel. Now, who are these watches for? Well, the Huawei GT2e is a decent smartwatch for people who are into fitness, but it's particularly useful and insightful for those who want to track a range of exercises. Also, if you're just turning towards a fitter lifestyle, you will enjoy an on-wrist personal trainer for your runs. For the keen athletes, GT2e also provides data like VO2 max, aerobic and anaerobic effect, training intensity, training load, in addition to recovery time stats. The GTR is a fashion watch, if there ever was one in the smartwatch world. It keeps up with the core tasks that a smartwatch should perform. For the occasional exercise, it is waterproof up to 50 meters and you also get inbuilt GPS. I think the 42mm version would fit male and the generally more slender female wrists. For the price points mentioned above, both Huawei GT2e and the GTR offer amazing value.
By the way, thank you to everybody who has already subscribed to the WesKnows channel. If you haven't though, please click on the red subscribe button below the screen to make sure you don't miss out on any of the new content coming out.
If you have enjoyed watching our video review, please push the subscribe button below the video and keep watching us for more honest reviews.